Welcome to the second part of our exhaust treatment workshop. We will now have a look on the creation of coated catalyst monoliths. We are now in the micro scale and not in the nanoscale anymore. So open GeoDict, and for first step I go to model grid geo, and here in the predefined sections, and here you can see different predefined scripts that we have written make it easier for you to create monolith structures. The Sonicom structure here at the first entry will create hexagonal channels, and we will also have some with the rectangular channels and with triangular channels. And here we have different kinds of types, so triangular and rectangular channels can be in DPF or a TVC mode, that means diesel particulate filter. Here you have a plugged structure, that means in the front and at the back the channels are closed with a plug. So you have for example for soot filtration you have a structure, and we will today create a TVC, so three-way catalyst structure that has no plugs. So click on this, and then we can set up how our model will look like. Click on the edit button, and here you can change some major settings. Okay, so first off we will have a little bit better resolution, 0.01 millimeter as voxel length. I will create a filter length of only 3 millimeters, and number of unit cells is by, and the wall thickness will be 0.2 millimeters, and I do not want to have inflow or outflow region, so in zeros here. All right, that's it. Click run. So we'll now create the basic structure. And here you can see how it looked like. It's a simple structure. But activate, show outlines, show halo for a little bit of nicer visibility. All right. Yeah, next step is to add some kind of coating. So this is the structure without catalytic wash coat. So what we will do is use the dilate function to add some coating. This can be found here by right clicking, go to dilate structure. Here we can choose what we want to dilate, which kind of coating material we want. Well, settings here are quite okay, so we will dilate on material one, on the red one, and then coating material with ID number two. And we only have to change down here this value of dilate by. And normally a wash coat layer is between 20 microns and 50 microns in thickness. So we can take something like 3 voxels. This would be right here with the voxel length. So 30 microns thickness. Just click run. And then you can see how will look like. So now we have a uniform coating on everything. Yeah, but there's a problem, because in reality our coating will never be uniform, but we would see some kind of thicker coating inside these corners here, and this is the next step what we are trying to do now. So to get some kind of coating in this sections, go to model grain geo and to add binder. This will add some material in corners and will be exactly what we want. So we click on edit, then options here for the add binder will change this added solid volume percentage down to 5% here, then that's basically it. We can say okay, generate, and this will now add this structure here in our corners. Yeah, perfect. Only thing that's not okay is the material color here, and this can be easily changed by changing the material ID. And this again, with right-clicking on structure here, go to reassign and then reassign material ID. And here you can choose that the yellow material, material number 3, will be changed to material number 2, to the green one. Just hit run, and now we have the same color from both of this added material. Yeah, and this is more or less like you would imagine it also to be in the nature in the real catalyst. Okay, all right. So let's have a look at a real catalyst layer or a real monolith wash code layer. So it's a little bit different because we're looking some kind like this here. This is a nice image from the University of Prague, and as you can see, their wash code layer is not really uniform, but it shows really, really hard drying cracks. And these drying cracks come from how it is produced. So normally you apply it as a slurry, that means you mix liquid and solid components and then pour it through your monolith, and then you will dry it with some high temperature over a little amount of time, so the liquid will evaporate again. And yeah, what stays are these drying cracks, and we want also to model these drying cracks now. Okay, so first I will save this structure because we will need it later. Let's go to save structure, and I will save it now as coded monolith. All right, and now we will create first a structure of only consisting of the cracks. And for that we will go to model, grain view, and create grains. Okay, and open this, and then you can check how large is your domain at the moment, and then you have to enter these values again here in our grain geo dialog. So nx is 320, ny is 277, and z is 300, and voxel length, change this to microns quickly, voxel length is 10 microns. So now we have the exact same values, so that we can combine our grain geo creating with the already existing monolith that we have now. All right, I will now go here to fixed objects number and say 1000. 1000 objects is all right. And object options, I will remove this ellipsoid, and I have only three spheres, and all of them have the same size, which is 80 microns. Okay, and the rest is and stay as it is. And just hit OK. Click generate. All right, and this is what you will get: some randomly placed 1,000 spheres. Yeah, does not look like cracks, but believe me, the next step will have a lot. So for the next step, we'll go to NGO, grow sediment. Now click on edit. Here, simply say exceed SVP 100%. So what grow sediment now does is increase each sphere's size more and more and more. It grows and grows until two of them will touch. And these touching interfaces will be marked in green color here. So we have activated these fine grain interfaces. And this is what we want to have at the end, because these interfaces will look perfectly like the cracks that form from dry cracking. All right. So I click on generate and wait a little bit, and we'll have this nice structure here. So you see this more or less random, nice, surface lines. All right. And what we do not want to have in this structure is our red material. We'll simply get rid of this by reassigning its material ID. So again, click on structure, right click, reassign material ID, and then say red material goes to zero material, so to raw material. All right. And this is what stay, some strange cracked structure. You will see how it works in the end. So I will now save this as cracks.gdt. And also I will save a dilated version of that. So just to make larger cracks, thicker cracks. So right click here and say dilate structure. I will dilate the green and coat it with the green again. But I will dilate only by one voxel. Right, click run. And now you see we have some kind of thicker structure before. I will also save this as rexthick.gdt. So, okay, here we go. Yeah, perfect. So now we have created our crack structure. And now we will use layer geo to combine both of these structures. So load your coded monolith again from before. We'll now the structure from the beginning. And now we go to structure, right click, say layer, then subtract. That means we can now subtract the crack GDT from our current structure. So open this, and here you can see different GDT files in your folder. If they are green, like all of these ones here, that means that their sizes match our current structure that we have here in our viewport. Yeah, and what we have to change down here is go to geometry mode and change it to voxel geometry, and also activate this subtract bitwise. So this means we will really subtract the green voxels with the green voxels from our cracked structure. All right, so I click on crack thick, click run, and this will now this year. You see we have now the cracks subtracted from our green material. Right, so this looks a little bit more like the image that you have seen lately. Hope this helps in creating some nice structure for you. Yes, all right, that's it for the second part. And the third part will start soon.